Royce, the Bank of Canada maintaining that neutral position in its March decision and holding on to that overnight policy rate of 5%. What did you get from the messaging?
Canadian central bankers are keeping their cards pretty close to their chest, but what I think was clear is that we're done with rate hikes. Rate cuts are on the horizon. It's just the timing and the magnitude that we have to leave in question after this March decision. They left the policy rate on hold, but they really didn't want to commit to any sort of guidance about lowering interest rates just yet.
What is going to signal a shift when it comes to the language in the April meeting that might support, I guess, everyone's expectation that we will see a cut by mid-year?
Up until this point, the Bank of Canada has been very concerned about the stickiness in inflationary pressures. What they're seeing is that inflation is still not on a track towards their 2% target. We will get more inflation data between now and the April rate decision. And if by then they start to concede that inflationary pressures are dissipating enough that they're confident that they can get price pressures back to being consistent with that 2% target, I think that would really open the door to a June rate cut.
And to your point, we will get more information from the Bank of Canada when they release the monetary policy report early April. That, of course, is ahead of the federal budget, which is set to be tabled, I guess, middle of April. How do those two worlds collide?
There's absolutely an overlap between fiscal policy and monetary policy. The Bank of Canada needs to take fiscal policy into account when it's setting monetary policy. So if the government comes out with large spending intentions or bigger budget deficits than anticipated, well, then the bank might not be as willing to cut as soon as it would have otherwise. That's the way these two interact. It's really about the Bank of Canada needing to get clarity about the situation from the federal government about its spending intentions, because up until this point, we know that not only the federal government, but all levels of government have actually been adding to the demand pressures in the economy. And the Bank of Canada hasn't been too thrilled about that. And Governor Macklem hasn't been shy about saying so. So the Bank of Canada will be paying very close attention to the federal budget that's coming out in mid-April.
Let's just go back and talk about some of those underlying inflationary pressures that are still hanging around. Where does the labor market factor in? What's the central bank saying there?
So the labor market has eased significantly over the past couple of years. You know, a few years ago, labor shortages were being talked about at just about every company in Canada. Now, much less so. There's still pockets of labor shortages, but they're isolated. What the central bank is saying now is that actually the labor market has eased so much that wage pressures are starting to cool off. Still in the early days of this, we don't have a full picture of what's happening in terms of wage growth, but we're starting to see signs that wage growth is cooling, and that matters because the bank believes that wage growth can drive inflation higher if it's too strong. If it cools down, the bank will be more comfortable thinking that wages are not going to be what's keeping inflation above their 2% target.
Let's talk about the housing market. The governor of the Bank of Canada mentioning that housing is still a sticky point when it comes to their decision making.
Shelter is by far the largest category contributing to inflation right now. Excluding shelter inflation, and you know, overall price pressures are easily in line with 2%. So what's driving that is mortgage interest costs, rent costs, and home prices. Right now, rent costs and mortgage interest costs are very high and they continue to rise every month. And that's really putting a lot of upward pressure on shelter prices. What the bank is worried about is if they start to cut interest rates, well, then that could reignite house prices as well. So they're in a tough spot. The bank wants to think about overall inflation, which includes shelter inflation, but it has to be looking at inflation excluding shelter as well to get a gauge of what's happening outside of the housing market, because there's really very little that the Bank of Canada can do to lower shelter inflation in the near term. What needs to happen is we need to build more houses. What the Bank of Canada can control is inflation excluding shelter. And I think they're getting more confident that that is coming more into line with their goals of slow and steady price increases.
Just lastly, Royce, are the Federal Reserve and the Bank of Canada pretty much aligned with their messaging, with both, I guess, central banks suggesting it's still too early?
Up until now, the U.S. Federal Reserve and the Bank of Canada have been very aligned in their messaging that they want to see more progress on the inflation front. But things could start to move in different directions if the Canadian economy continues to sputter and the U.S. economy continues to outperform. Right now, inflation in both countries has come down almost as fast as it went up, which is great news. The problem is in Canada, it came along with very weak GDP growth. In the U.S., we've seen very strong GDP growth. If those two themes continue into the middle of the year and into next year, we could see interest rate cuts in both countries, but maybe the Bank of Canada needing to cut more to offset that economic weakness here at home.